just what I needed.
Parted again.
What's wrong with him?
But if you can do it, then so could I!
Let's give this a try. Not bad.
Coming, Kuka!
you go!
Mortimer.
What do you want?
Your soul is tainted with worthless human will, yet your thirst for power remains undiminished. With every sip you take, you grow in strength, and soon you shall achieve perfection.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You will accept us, Mythos. It is inevitable. You were created for this purpose, and you shall serve it.
Never!
You mitigate its weakness by interweaving it with your consciousness. We believed we had merely to purge you of your will to claim our vessel. It appears we first have to sever every thread of the consciousness that supports it. No matter. The time to build a new world is not yet upon us. We will contemplate.
Thank you, Joshua.
One can no more command the power of ether by drowning in its flood than one can constrain the tides by standing in the sea. I had thought Hugo wiser than this, but it seems his head was full of rocks after all.
Titan was strong.
Your Majesty.
But Mythos is stronger. For 5 years, that man lived only for revenge, clinging fast to a fiction even as it swept him into the abyss. One cannot change one's nature through force of will alone. Only the Almighty can do that.
Hugo Kupka, the man who gave his life for a woman's head. A fool like all the rest.
Of a mother crystal should be so beautiful.
Some medicine, my lord? I have salves, potions, anything you need.
Stop bothering me, urchin, or you'll feel the back of my hand.
You must consider your health, my prince. If a show of force is needed to keep the Dalmeks at bay, you may trust in your dragoons. I beg you to call on Bahamut only as a last resort. His strength comes at too great a cost.
The Empire agreed to an armistice with the Republic, and yet the Emperor still plots its ruin. For now, the Dalmex suspect nothing, and as long as I can hold their gaze, war need not be inevitable. But more than that, Bahamut is the champion of the Empire. When our people look to the heavens, the sight of him gives them hope. Forgive me, Terence. Would that you were my master. But alas.
I will always be your loyal servant.
Should the Council's brazen maneuvering prompt the Republic to tear up their own treaty and launch a new assault, our soldiers would advance to meet them, cutting across the central aisles, but not in time to prevent their forces from breaching the southern defenses and storming Twinside. And so the capital would become a battlefield. Thousands of innocents would die. I cannot allow that to happen.
There is one small mercy, at least. You will not be forced to do battle with Titan.
Would that I could avoid doing battle at all.
1,000 pardons, Your Highness.
What is it?
Olivier has been made Emperor. What is the meaning of this?
My father's orders. What were they? Quickly! Yes, Your Highness. His Radiance requests that Your Highness maintain position here and...
Gah!
Yes, my prince.
I must go to the palace.
I'll ready your steed.
What is it now?
Forgive the intrusion, Your Highness.
I know you.
At ease.
We stand in the presence of the Phoenix. You wouldn't want to get your fingers burned.
I hope I'm not interrupting.
Not at all. Though I admit, I did not expect such a distinguished guest.
How many years has it been since the remembrance ceremony? 20?
I thought you long dead. Do I address a ghost?
Many have told me that I look like one. But no. I'm alive. Just. Prince Dion of the House Lesage, I have a tale to tell you.
I'd better give Otto the good news.
Walkways
at the moment, Sid.
Seeing troops amassing at every border crossing.
No surprises there. It was the same after Drake's breath.
Clive, you're back.
I am. And with glad tidings for once. Hugo Kupka is no more.
Well, I'll be. All of our comrades who lost their lives back at Sid's place be smiling down at you right now.
We had a stallus from Lubor saying Drake's fang had fallen. I expect that was your doing as well, was it?
It's a long story.
One for the history books, I'll bet.
Welcome home, Clive.
It's good to be back. You look better.
I feel it. Which means I'm coming on your next little adventure. You're not leaving me behind again.
Wouldn't dream of it. Otto. Any word on the Royalist movements since I've been away?
Shouldn't you be putting your feet up? If you really want to know, go and have a word with Vivian.
Thank you. I will.
The conquering hero returns, and with hardly a scratch on him.
I may have picked up one or two.
Well, the fact that you came straight to me instead of visiting our resident physica suggests that you picked up something more important. A scent. The scent of Weluders.
The very same. But whatever plans Kupka was hatching with the Royalists, he took them to his grave. As did his men, slaughtered by the orcs who'd taken over the Fang. Orcs, Vivian. I've never seen such creatures in Storm before. The Weluders must have ferried them over from Ash, but why? Why work to rescue Kupka only to invade his home, the mother crystal of an allied nation, and let both fall? It makes no sense.
Do you know the tale of the blind men and the Adamantus? One can often be led astray by focusing too closely on individual details. One must instead see the bigger picture. And what bigger picture is there than my map? The Kingdom of Walud claims dominion over all of Ash. It is a nation forged by the bloody conquest of Barnabas Tharm, the dominant of Odin. The Canvarian War of Independence in 849. The Battle of the Twin Realms in 865. The Battle of Belinus Tor in 873. Wheresoever his armies fought, Odin was found where the fighting was fiercest. But of late, the warrior king appears to have laid his sword to rest. Battle rages for control of the crystalline dominion. Yet Tharm sends not a single ship in support of his Dalmechian allies. Meanwhile, the blight ravages great swathes of Ash. Yet warlike Walud shows not the faintest interest in laying claim to untouched lands. So why go to the trouble of sending an army of orcs into the heart of Drake's Fang, only to make no attempt to claim the Mother Crystal for Walud? It can hardly be for lack of men. Tharm's armies rival any in the Twins. No. We have not seen the last of the Waluda standard. Odin will ride again. It is but a question of when. And on that day, who will be trampled underfoot? In summary, I know not to what end the Royalist betrayed Kupka. I know only that it is part of some broader scheme. A scheme tied to the ambitions of one man.
King Barnabas.
But there is no need to wallow in confusion. If one is to cure a sickness, one must first identify the symptoms. And your Lord Uncle has volunteered to do just that by keeping an eye on the Royalists' movements.
He's really throwing himself into this.
Indeed he is. Which means all that remains for us to do is await his reports. Well, not quite all in your case. The people of the Hideaway must hear the news. Justice has been done. Hugo Kupka is dead. The wounds he left that night are still raw. Especially for those who lived with Cid the longest. Tell them that those wounds might finally begin to heal. Consider it the price of today's instruction.
I've never known you to be sentimental.
What can I say? I am only human. And we are, all of us, sentimental animals at heart.
I suppose we are. Very well. I'll go and spread the word.
And how may I assist you today? One must understand one's place in the world. Of course. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.